smash that like button down there for us, all right? Hit that bell for notifications.
Like my video and subscribe below.
That's a real fuck up.
Too far. Sorry.
All right. Enough of that.
Jeffrey is here this morning. Good morning, Jeffrey. How are you?
Yo, what's up?
I don't know. You tell me. What's happening?
I'm here.
Okay. All right. All right.
We're going to do a show, or are you just going to pick at me all day?
What is your problem, dude?
That's how you're doing.
Other than that, I'm alive. Listen, and doing fine.
Just go sit in the hallway or go home. I don't care either way, to be honest with you. I mean, what a pissy attitude this guy has. I say good morning, how are you? And you start bitching and moaning like
sorry,
a crybaby. You
know,
are a crybaby. You need to go home and spend time with that stupid-ass, dumb, whatever that clown is that you hang out with. You need to, you and your girlfriend over there, just hang out, and maybe you should never come back in here.
So let me ask you this, are you going to completely go clean shave, or are you going to go back to the old goatee the way I remember when I first met you? You just had a goatee on.
Don't ever go back to the goatee.
I might just start ripping off all your facial hair.
The
chin strap. Oh, no need to do that. Uh-huh. Then my face will be a bloody mess, dude.
Well, we have an idea for him.
Why would your face be a bloody
ripping
mess?
Off his hair.
Well, if you were... Robert,
oh, my God. Are you serious?
Didn't you start dating B1 before she was 21?
I never took her to a bar
you
once.
Okay, all right.
But
you
never.
How are you talking? God, you just make stuff up.
You never
You
drank.
Lump me exactly in with all these other jack wipes you've had that worked here. It's ridiculous.
Hold on. You
the only underage drinks that got fed to her were the bitch across you that took her to the tailgate and gave her beers behind my back to try to get me in trouble. So if you want to go down that road, we can go down that road.
You're talking about something that happened 10 years ago.
You talk about stuff I did 20 years ago every other damn day, so what's the damn difference?
What is your problem?
Oh, my God. I'm sorry I'm not just blindly kissing ass. I'm sorry. I'll just blindly kiss ass. Jesus. God.
Man, you have an attitude problem.
So
what
do you.
What is your problem?
So
I have,
do
I have
all
an
you.
Attitude problem?
Yes, you all have an attitude all the time. So what?
Really, what attitude problem do I have? When I'm covering your ass for things with iHeart? When I'm defending you all the goddamn time? That's when I have an attitude problem, dumb? I just want to be clear. That's when I have an attitude problem? Are you serious?
I'm sorry I didn't just kiss your ass there.
Kiss my ass? Screw that. Why don't you... Dude, I am so
goddamn
fed up.
What are you
going to
do? You're going to come beat me up, tough guy?
No, do some work around here. I am so fed up. You don't do squat.
Look at the topic list. Like, did you put any topics in, bitch? You want to call me not working? You didn't do any work last night. Did you do any work?
Dumb, I did.
Did you do any work?
I did do work.
We filled up the stuff with topics. You're going to drag one thing over. Don't tell me to do work.
Thank you.
Don't tell me to do work. You didn't do diddly last night.
Tell me the last time you got a guest on this show.
McAuliffe. Fresnick, Scobie.
Yeah.
Onizuka.
Uh-huh.
That's
three of them. You guys can
McCullough,
be able to Google
Fresnick, Scobie, Onizuka. That's how many?
That's three of them so far. This crew is seven.
McAuliffe, Resnick, Scobie, Onizuka. How many do we have there?
That's three of them so far. I try to tell you that, Rover. I don't know what you're getting at here. What the joke is?
I'm pretty sure it was Ronald something.
Ronald McNair.
No.
There you go.
That was the black man on the that died in the Challenger accident. Who was on that crew?
All right,
Ronald McNair.
So that's his name. Okay. So now we have McAuliffe, Resnick, Scobie, Onizuka. And McNair, how many do we have now?
That's four so far.
Just count in your head.
All right, one more time, Rover. I want to hear this.
Say the names.
Okay, so we have McAuliffe, Resnick, Scobie, Onizuka, and McNair.
That's five now. Okay. All right, now we're up to five.
Oh, no, I feel his breath on me. It stinks like donkey dung, and he'll always be so damn dirty with turds and juicy runs. So filthy, covered with sewage, he sprays it from his bum.
Oh, perfect. Hit it. All right. Just in time, Jeffrey.
We are Dolo Roke.
sorry crew. Come on down and get covered in poop. Smells so bad, you know it's true. This is a Pooper Bowl party invitation for you. It's a Super Bowl party at Jeffrey's house. And when you leave, you'll need to be deloused. Pooper Bowl XL, let's have some fun. It's free admission for everyone. Staring at a ceiling fan, stuck in a trance. Jeffrey smelling like he dropped the juice in his pants. Playing naked trucker with some calendar girls. Streaking up his undies with Doodoo Swirls. Come over this Sunday for a party, y'all. Everyone is invited, we're gonna have a ball. It's the Super Bowl party of the century. The Pooper Bowl party with your boy Jeffrey.
Pooper Bowl at Jeffrey's house.
I'm not kidding. I actually, when I hung up using Gorilla Glue, I put a soap dish in my shower because I'd stepped on the other one and broke it when I was fat. And then I went, let's see how strong this thing is. And it held me up. I couldn't believe it.
You're saying that you're 400?
Yeah. Yes.
Your biggest piece of trash yourself?
Yes.
Yes. Whoa, really?
Yes.
400?
Yes.
It actually holds up a gorilla.
That's
some real death metal, you know?
But I'm bummed. Is this a... Could this possibly be real? Is this a real skeleton? I mean, that's gross if it is. That's disgusting.
At the end, you can... I think he zooms in a bit.
Wow.
You can see...
It's kind of cool, though.
I think that's actually pretty neat.
That's the literal term of death metal. Literally. It is lonely in my room. I keep telling her, the boy gets lonely. Aww. Come on, you got to do something.
Do you ever send her a dick pic?
No, she has a smartphone.
She does or doesn't?
No, she doesn't.
Pick up the phone and dial her.
All right, but just pretend you're...
Why not?
Yeah, just
kids
call
at her. My son's at home. He's doing his remote learning. And I'm nice try, guys.
You've left some filthy messages on that machine before.
Dirty. Oh, I'm not doing that.
Let's pretend, Jeffrey, you're describing... Hello, I graduate from here.
I say, hey, look, you want to see a hot dick? You want to see the boy?
Who is this?
Yeah, who is this?
It's your husband.
Oh, you're not scheduled till next week.
Real funny, dude.
So he used to ride around on the street on his bike with wearing his sister's dress. And he'd do a stupid thing again. He'd go, yo, Dieter. He'd ride around the cul-de-sac.
Yo, I'm a Dieter.
Yo, Dieter, yo. Uh-huh.
Hold on. Here's the worst part.
Yeah.
There wasn't a seat on the bike.
Oh,
Dieter, that's confirmed. Dieter used to wear a dress and ride around on a bike with no seat.
And me, I actually went to a Catholic school, believe it or not. Only for 2 years, though. Only for kindergarten and first grade.
You got kicked out, right?
Well, what happened was I was going to St. Vincent de Paul, which was a church that was like right up the street from my house where I lived at the time.
Right?
I lived on 134th Street.
Uh-huh.
Wow, I can't even tell a story without even being interrupted.
I know.
That's droll, dude.
That's what?
I just got that from Fred Flintstone. So, as I was saying, if you let me continue my...
Yabba dabba don't.
Whatever, dude.
He waited for you to leave, and he knew you were coming right back, and that's when he accidentally spilled the water.
I mean,
water.
What kind of dipshit leaves water on a metal surface that's slippery when you know, A, you have an injured person that you're dealing with, a friend who you'd want to look out for.
Yeah, I mean, we can't forget it.
Or even just if he's not a friend, just a goddamn colleague who you'd want to look out for. You know what I'm saying? So you'd think you'd
I'm trying,
say...
Maybe I'll be straight up trying to take you out. I'm tired of the noises.
Like.
I'm tired of the noises. I want to see you. I dropped you off a couple days ago, or maybe last week, and I usually just leave. But the ground was really snowy one time.
I saw you wait for me. That was so nice of you.
No, it was waiting to see if you would eat shit. Seriously.
Curious George, this is him on a sled
or
something?
He was sled riding with his nephews.
Okay, all right. Here it is.
You can see.
Oh, gosh. Oh, my back.
Oh! Oh! That guy says my back before even
Well, no, the
bumpy.
When you go down, Snitz, that bump is just killing your back. You're not on a, he's not on an inner tube.
He doesn't know it's going to get worse in a second.
Back. Oh,
those plastic saucers suck.
And he said he's going to bring them in today.
Where are they?
He's going to wash them.
I done told you on the main show I did not bring them in because they have not been washed yet.
Oh.
And my and I asked my wife, did you wash my pants? You know, the ones I normally like to wear the putter around the house in. She said,
up.
No, because, okay, dude, you, just
shut the fuck up.
Let me talk. As I was saying before I was rudely interrupted.
You really don't think you could do... Almost a full load. I think you could.
Oh, a fucking cement mixer truck. You can fill that shit up and do laundry.
I do that better, dumb. So shut up.
I'm wondering what you thought of his interview with Rover on the radio.
Honestly,
program.
I thought it was a really good interview.
Thank you.
But
okay.
I wouldn't be interested in dating him.
Nobody's that. Nobody's asking that. Do you think all gay dudes are just so fuck crazy they just want to fuck every guy they see?
He is with every chick, so
that's what I'm wondering. Yes. Like, do you think that Dr. Court just wants to fuck every dude he sees?
We've discussed it. You have one of the worst butts we've ever seen. Most gay guys would try to steer clear of that.
Yeah,
kind of situation.
Well, they'd probably open that book and then quickly close
yes,
it right
okay,
back.
Not for me.
They judge the book by its cover.
Yes, and they go, this bubble butt.
Did he just unleash in there?
Yeah, this was silent though.
This is great.
Or it's just natural? Is this natural smell or is this a fart?
This is natural.
Oh,
just your natural odor.
No, not my natural odor. It was just a natural fart.
Do a smell right now, Dieter. Just see if you get her.
Oh my God!
So bad.
Wow.
Jeffrey, what happened? Did you crap yourself?
No, I didn't crap myself. I just farted.
Sure? Dieter, how bad is it? I mean, honestly, how bad is it?
No, the second you'll know when we go to commercial. Walk outside this door, and immediately hit you in the face is rotten eggs.
Somebody's just walked by and screamed, "Oh my God, it's in the hallway!"
Who?
The fart. We don't know. The person's gone.
They smelled it walking down the hallway, which is about 20 yards away.
It's that bad.
Step out.
Oh my God!
Yeah, I mean,
see,
it's the building's ruined.
He crapped his
right
pants.
There.
Dude, that is.
He crapped his pants.
Rotten.
I'm telling you, dude.
He crapped his pants.
That's not a normal fart.
Jeffrey, you okay?
Did you crap yourself?
Because it doesn't stick. It doesn't stick around like this.
Number
There's matter.
Three?
There is matter in your underwear right now.
Oh,
turn around.
All right. Now.
Oh.
Did you look at the pants?
Well, it's very quick. No, I looked at the crack.
Can we just check the underwear real quick?
A new smell started.
Oh, really? Oh.
It's the underwear. You got to look at the underwear.
Uh-oh, Charlie's hurling.
Oh, this is the guy walking past. Oh, they gotta be smelling it down there.
Oh,
he just did it again.
Oh,
what?
He just what happened?
Again. This one had volume.
Wait, this
Charlie has a
underpants on
underwear.
Inside out, first of all.
He has them on inside out?
What are you saying?
Oh! Oh, that's a shark.
He sharted?
Oh, yeah.
That's a shart? Can you confirm it? How can you confirm that's a shart?
What did you see?
Dieter, go. Get your phone. Take a picture. Someone take a picture.
What happened?
Well, you didn't go in the house?
Is it like a thing, like an attraction that you can go inside?
Oh my God,
the original reason we wanted to go down there was because they have this unofficial Lego museum that used to be that's in an old disused school. And we went down there before when my kids were a lot younger, and we wanted to see if they added new stuff.
So what? Okay, so tell me, did they add new stuff in the Lego museum?
No, because we came up to the place, and the gates were closed, and it just says closed for the season. And I looked at the hours, and it says the hours didn't say anything about it being closed for the season while I looked it up on the website.
I love it.
So you drove to an unofficial bootleg Lego museum that was closed.
It's closed.
It's just some guy's house that had some Legos.
When the show gets recorded, there are multiple segments, and then they're all put together. If there's a segment already in there, it gets mashed in there together. So it's just me shirtless, clapping to test the sync.
Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2.
There you go.
Yeah, what would people think?
You shirtless, it's dark.
I believe Jeffrey Allen LaRoque is on with us. Good morning, Jeffrey.
Oh, is there a blackout? Is there a blackout in your house?
Is the power out? What's going on there?
Let me refresh.
Holy crap. It's completely pitch dark in his house, and you can see the outline of his face.
Yes, that's it. Jeffrey, good morning. What are you... Why don't you have any lights on in the house?
Morning.
Hi, good morning.
Morning.
Jeez.
Is he listening to us?
No, it's not a blackout in my house.
Are you listening to us in delay?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course there's lights on in my house.
Yeah, he's about a minute behind Robles. Who's going to hear this in a minute?
Wood says that he's looking forward to making his return to the video game landscape, and with 2K and HB Studios,
he just fell off his chair.
They found the right...
Hold on.
He just fell back off his chair.
Are you serious?
Hold on a sec.
He was yawning.
What? What? Jeffrey,
I can't see what's going on
He's
right
on
now.
The floor.
Don't cut
did,
away.
Did he pass out?
Oh, there he is.
Are his knees okay?
I don't think he has his headphones on. Hold on.
He's yawning and stretching.
You all right there, Jeffrey?
Yeah, I'm all right.
What happened?
The chair I have is something my parents gave me, and I tried to move it downstairs to use it, and I brought it back upstairs. One of the casters broke off, so it's not balanced.
Were you leaning back to yawn, and you fell out of your chair?
Yeah, I was leaning. I leaned back a little too far to yawn. So I got $5,600.
Whoa!
Oh my God!
Holy crap! That's another full tax return he just got back.
He got more money in his past two tax checks than I will bring home from the radio station this entire year. Oh. A year!
It's probably covered in Vaseline. That whole room.
There's something else.
There's like a makeshift vagina over your left shoulder, Jeffrey. Look over your left shoulder.
Oh, God.
Your other left. Your other left. Hit the unmute button.
Yes. Yeah. Refresh.
I heard her rustling around earlier.
Yes, yes. You were right, literally right before the show started. I had to mute you because
Hello?
In here.
Oh, whoa. What'd you take?
Whoa, what happened there?
Oh. Okay, so I clicked mute on the screen. It's showing
what?
Mute.
Yeah, hit unmute.
I'm telling you.
Crazy. Yeah, but I can't. Dush, stop it.
We can't see.
I could replace Anthony.
Dush, stop. Thank you.
What?
Dieter is here.
Nope.
Yeah, find this mute button again.
Oh, my God.
Look at this.
Oh, my God.
Wait, how does this work? Damn you, Rover.
She can't get the webcam back on her computer.
Oh, man, looks like Blair Witch Project.
Yeah.
No, every venue is different. So depending on each individual couple's needs is how I'll, adapt.
You tailor your services to each individual couple's needs is what you're saying, Dom.
Echo.
Put that in my flyer.
Hey, Dad, when are you going to change your shirt?
I got you.
Hey, Dad, when are you going to change your shirt? When are you going to change your shirt? When are you going to change your shirt?
Don't worry about it.
God, this guy's going to lose it. His head's going to explode.
Is that his daughter tapping him on the shoulder there?
It's just things.
His son farted on him, said he's wearing the same shirt. His wife's yelling at him. This guy's going to lose it.
His boy, daughter giving him a bunny ears.
All right, hold on. Jeffrey, calm down.
Change your shirt.
Oh, my God.
Dad, change your shirt.
Hi, Tomas.
Change your shirt.
Oh, my God.
Hi,
he's shirtless.
And a guy pulls up in a Jeep and gets out and shakes my hand. He says, what's your name? I said, Tom. I go, what's your name? He said, Doug. I go, oh, Doug, you look like Dieter from Rover. He goes, yeah, I get that all the time. Well, it was Dieter. And Dieter, my wife, wanted to say thank you, and so did, my cat wants to say thank you.
Dieter, did you sell this guy a cat stroller?
I did.
What?
Oh, my God.
What?
I love it.
What? Doug, he says his name is.
Yeah,
Doug?
And I didn't shake his hand, by the way. He's lying about that.
What's going on there?
Oh, it's the chair.
What are you doing?
Oh, it's my chair squeak when I rock on it.
Well, don't rock
on
it.
Yeah, when you hear the squeak, we hear it. I mean.
Just stop doing it. Why? Stop! Why can't you stop doing it?
Jeffrey, we'll see you on Wednesday.
Yep, I'll be there.
Okay, all right. Don't
sound... out, guns out. If the weather, okay. Is conducive.
Okay, all right. Even
Wait,
if
did
not,
he, did he trim his armpits?
Yes.
During the break.
Oh.
Put your arms up.
Put your arms up, bud. He did.
Wait, you trimmed your
Dude,
pits?
He
did you
his
shave
hair
your
off.
Armpit hair
Ew.
During the show?
No, it's during the last commercial break. You guys run.
So that's
run
during the show. Yeah.
Jeffrey, go get the laptop. I need to see this.
Laugh it up, boys. Laugh it
Don't
up.
Get the laptop. I need
a grown
to see.
Man kicking in a room in his own house. What's not funny about that? The new next tool to try this with. He just walked into his bedroom, grabbed something off the floor. What's on the what tool chest do you have just laying on the floor?
It's in a different spot.
What are you looking for? Boudoir photo shoot. What do you think about that, dude? It's just you, Mary Elizabeth.
Ass to butt posing.
Ass to butt.
Oh.
Ass
to, what?
Ass to ass, butt.
What is it? Butt to ass. Butt.
Butt to butt? What is that what you're saying?
You're talking about you're saying ATM. Ass to.
No.
Now that would
she's
be a calendar.
You and Jeffrey riding a motorcycle, nuts to butts.
Oh, nuts to butts.
That makes sense. You don't have nuts.
You guys don't have nuts. Yeah.
Yeah, you gotta have nuts in the first place.
My dog can now catch a frisbee, so I'm really proud.
Ooh, that is cool. Yeah, hell yeah.
Cool. I have a frisbee.
You jump
dog.
And get it and everything.
Yeah,
that's cool.
So Carl left or Craig or whatever left his dog at my place, and he said it'd be cool if you taught my dog how to catch a frisbee. And I said I'm on it. I got it. Throw this frisbee. She doesn't catch it. She grabs the frisbee and runs off with it and just won't give it back, and I'm pulling on it. And then she grabs it and she brings it over the corner of my yard, drops it, and I go to grab it, but she starts pissing all over it. Just pissing on the frisbee. And it's upside down, so it's collecting.
Oh, nice.
Pooling.
Oh, okay. Cool.
My dog immediately runs up and just starts drinking that piss.
Yeah, it looks like at some points it did break. It's almost like that trick the clown does, the magician, where he pulls those handkerchief out of his
out of his sleeve, and it just keeps coming and coming.
Yeah, so they're doing that with his ass. Small and large intestine connect them. It's
okay. Together, your small and large intestines are about 15 feet in length.
Exactly. See, okay. I knew. Just I knew. I heard it.
Just a shy short of a mile.
Just a bit outside.
A mile.
So he's at the car wash yesterday.
Uh huh.
And he's filming himself at the car wash, trying to look sweet. Okay, watch. All right, now, I'm going to slow it down here so you can really get it. So he's trying to look sweet at the car wash. Now,
what?
Yeah, what am I? What?
His back window's wide open and water is...
Oh, no!
Wait, where?
Look behind him. Right here. Yeah, look behind him. Yeah.
He's trying to look so sweet.
Guys, this show might actually raise your sperm count. And ladies, if you hang out with Rover, he's definitely going to raise your sperm count.
If you listen to Rover's Morning Glory, the guy, you know, for the guys, they would raise their sperm count. But he also said the same thing about women. And I'm saying to myself, wouldn't women don't make sperm? I thought only men do that to get the girl pregnant.
He got you, boss.
You got me.
I would say you. That is an inaccuracy. Yeah. It should be egg count. Women carry eggs.
So this
men
show
carry sperm
raises
because men use the sperm to fertilize the woman's eggs to get the girl pregnant. Am I right?
So this show raises women's egg counts.
Duji, I'm very disappointed that you dropped the ball on this one, but I forgive you because you know you drop the ball all the time. But, but I'm just saying, I'm just you know. So
there is the picture.
Yay!
Of
hold it up, for
Lady
the camera.
Caca and Stink.
That's
there
huge.
It is. Yes.
Are we gonna do a suck off against?
Well, I'm sorry. Say that again. Can
a
you what?
Suck off.
A like show suck off. Yeah.
Man, two just dumped that. You know.
No.
Yeah,
yeah, two members of the show have a suck off.
So where Dieter sucks off against Jeffrey. And then whoever's the fastest wins.
And then we find, yeah, we just go
or,
through
who's
bracket
the champ,
style.
Uh-huh. The best sucking off.
What if some dribbles out of the hole?
Some free sun, you mean?
Oh, wow. Wow. This whole segment is not airing, Rover. You know it's not. Man, dude,
just,
email me
just a little,
what you're
a little
right
dribbling
now.
Out. Huh? Okay. Go. He just ripped off the straw. He's all right. Little came out. A little pre-sun came out, but he's now sucking. He's got the straw in. He's sucking. He's sucking it down. He's really sucking.
Oh wow, this
he's
is hard.
He's squeezing the pouch.
Done.
Go. All right. He's unwrapping the straw.
Start.
He's
rough
jamming.
Start. Oh, money
shot. Money shotted it out. All right, he's squeezing the bag.
Oh, you're dribbling
wow,
it on
really
your mouth.
Oh,
wait
it.
A second.
Check it.
Check it.
Check
is that
bag.
Empty?
It's
is it empty.
Empty?
Check that.
Squeeze
it.
It's
oh,
empty.
Wow. Go. All right, he's having a little trouble with the straw.
He gave me the straw open.
Just, don't squeeze it.
All right, there. He just got it into the pouch. He's now squeezing the hell out of this pouch. He's squeezing and sucking. He's really slurping it down. He's going hard and
wow.
fast. All right, 17.21.
Oh!
Go. Okay. Right. He's ripped off the straw. He's opening the straw. He's having a little trouble with the straw.
Why did it hit it on the table?
Still,
there's a pointy side
is still,
to the straw.
He's stabbing. No. He's pointing the straw. He might have put a hole in the straw.
See, there's a pointy side
now
to the straw.
He's still
not
trying
using
to unwrap
it.
The straw. We're 14 seconds in. Straw still not unwrapped. Now, 16 seconds in. He's got it unwrapped. He's sticking the straw into the pouch. The straw is now in his mouth. He's squeezing the pouch and he's sucking.
Oh, double-handed technique. And he's kind of milking it out. Yes. That's interesting. I've seen this in videos online.
Come on. Come on.
Dribbling,
suck
dribbling.
It down. Suck it. Suck
dribble,
it. Come
dribble,
on.
Dribble, dribble, dribble.
Suck. Go. She's ripped off the straw. She's
same problem as Jeffrey. She's wrong side.
She's all right. Now she's finally sticking the straw into the pouch. Took her about 9 seconds. Squeeze, squeeze
I think she
that
poked
bag
out the other side.
Oh, it's
squeeze
on the
that bag. Squeeze that bag.
Swallow.
Come on.
Really
suck
massaging
down
it.
She's gagging.
Come on,
on
take it
it
all.
She's gagging.
Mm.
More of a milking.
You got to toothpaste it. Yeah, there you go.
Go.
Oh.
Oh, he's dropped. Go.
Damn it.
Sorry. Right.
Oh.
Go.
Ah.
There you go.
This guy's.
Now he's flat squeezing just like she did.
Oh, it's harder.
Is it harder? Mm-hmm. Oh, that's it then. You guys caught it.
Mm-hmm.
And you're even crushed it. See, he's
flat
still
squeeze
crushed
is
it
impossible to
wow,
go
that's
faster.
20 seconds.
Then that's probably part of the rules.
Yep.
That's the rule.
Did this
another failure for
Dunn. Damn, your dad's gonna so not proud of you.
Dad is so disappointed.
Take that, Dad. Oh. Jeffrey consoled him.
The back.
It looks like he has a little Star Trek uniform on almost, doesn't it? It's all right.
Thank God it's not red.
What? Yes, he'd be dead.
What?
Why?
It's a nerd joke.
Yeah.
All right, you guys, do you need a room?
What?
I don't understand it.
We're not supposed to. We're not nerdy.
What else do we have,
Charlie? That's Star Trek, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, let's do that.
He's going back to the bathroom to look on top of the toilet paper roll.
No, that's possible. That's where else would they be? He takes them off when he takes a crap.
He didn't think about that until Dieter just said it.
Well, what is he, where did he walk
they're
to
right
then?
On the floor they're here. Right here they the fell on the floor.
They've been here for 2 hours.
If he just looks down, he'll clearly
he can't,
right
he can't
there
see, Charlie, unless he gets on his hands and knees.
That's kind of the point. Maybe we're could maybe leave the glasses on.
Yeah.
So you can see the host like last week. You couldn't see Rover.
Yeah, he thought it was me sitting in the seat. It was actually Dieter.
He might not know. And then, are you going to talk as...
Is he back yet?
Come on, he's back, right. Finally. Jeez.
Any luck?
Now, Jeffrey, what was the last place you saw your glasses?
All I remember was the last place I was in the last commercial break, I was using the bathroom.
Okay.
Did you have the glasses then?
No, I had them clipped right here.
Uh-huh.
So... Where do you think they went?
I have no effing clue.
Are you worried?
Yeah, nice try, Dieter. I know you're a nice try, Dieter. Nice freaking try, dude.
You a minute.
So if you do you keep taking them on and off? Do you think you maybe put them on?
On the counter there or something?
Yeah,
or
look there.
Look around your general area right now.
Maybe. Oh, not in the trash. No, it's not in the trash. I'm telling you,
through the
it's
trash?
Not in the trash.
Jeffrey.
Oh.
Where were they?
Under the counter.
Oh.
Why not put them on?
Yeah, put them on his shirt.
Put them
again
on.
They only share the bras.
You don't share.
They share panties.
They wear underwear, not panties, dude. They don't even wear lingerie.
What do you mean they don't wear panties?
They both wear standard women's underwear for their appropriate size.
Yeah, they're called panties, dumbass. What are you talking about?
What do you think?
What are panties? Just like you just associate that with
not thongs,
silk and lingerie and
just regular panties,
no,
right?
Just women's underwear is called panties.
Oh, whatever, dude.
Well, what does it look like?
Like women's underwear.
He thinks tampons
fancy
go up people's butts.
All right, so you got your family a bra to share.
Nice.
Who got?
I don't wear that. Nice fucking try, dude.
So your wife is wearing your daughter's bra and your son's jeans.
No, she doesn't wear my son's. She just tried them on to see if they would fit.
And did they?
Yeah.
That's why they just buy unisex clothes. I mean, they're just, it's just going back and forth.
So what
and
size
left and
do you
right
think your wife wears? You think she wears a 16?
I have no fucking clue. That would be I would venture to say that.
Well, what size does she wear?
I just told you.
16.
Are you fucking?
So when you go
are
in
you
the
fucking deaf,
he thinks it's his wife, Mary Elizabeth.
We get the voice down. The voice is for sure.
Peter.
Funny.
Peter.
Charlie, you missed it. Mary Elizabeth is running the show.
That's just Rover trying to.
No, it's Mary.
That's Rover. So nice Mary's try,
dude. Oh, she's wearing the t-shirt.
Baby. I'm bleeding.
She's wearing the I graduated from here, her own shirt.
This looks so real.
is this a pretty accurate costume that someone sent me? The little glasses here.
And I heard if you die with an erection, it stays in an erection.
No.
Yes.
Isn't that blood flow?
No, but that's the body stays and then turns into rigor mortis. And if you have an erection, you die. Stays that way.
How do they close the casket?
If you do an open casket, you have to saw it off. Put it in the guy's pocket.
Little hole in the.
Krista didn't know. I don't know if I already mentioned this before. She didn't know bats are just like out. She's like, look at that weird bird flying very erratically. Is you think it's a seizure? Or like, and I was like, bitch, that's a bat. She's like, what? And I said, yeah, there's bats. And she's like, no, we're not by a cave or anything. I was like, oh, bats were around all the time.
There's a castle. There's no castle around here.
And she had no idea. She thought they were just funny
birds. Yeah, from my read, bats don't have the best eyesight either.
Well, no, they use the...
Blind as a bat, yeah.
Yeah, there's a phrase.
I don't know how you guys are getting your doge right now, but you have to go to some weird market?
No.
No, probably Robin Hood.
I'm on Robin Hood.
Oh, it's on Robin... Oh.
But you don't really own it from Robin Hood, so...
Yeah, Stitz, I thought you were done with Robin Hood.
I don't get it from Robin Hood.
I do.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
You
angry.
Yeah, you just said,
well, you said what normal people
Robin
get
Hood,
it from.
And I go, I
do
thought
not...
you were done with it.
No.
I don't use it. You just said you get it from
no,
Robin Hood.
No, I did not say I got it from there. I said she got it from there.
I do.
How
could
dare
ruin
you
it
make
all.
That accusation?
Yeah, don't ever compare... Don't
I
ever,
swear he said...
Don't ever put me and Robin Hood in the same sentence, please.
Yeah. So you go somewhere else?
Yes, of course I do. You don't...
I tried to have a conversation with him in the bathroom a minute ago, and he wanted nothing to do with it. I don't know
what, about the mask. Isn't... So, you're still wearing a mask?
This is like
that's a conversation,
like a professional bowler.
And then it followed with, "Do you want me to put one on?"
And I don't care. You're the one who's brought it up. I'm just sitting there going to the bathroom.
Leave him alone, man.
Let the guy take a leak.
Sorry, dude. I
My
won't
Lord,
talk to you
people.
Anymore.
Wait, Snitz is in there taking a whiz, has his mask on. It's time to speculate. Dumb walks in without a mask on and asks Snitz, do you want me to put a mask
no,
on?
No, he did not say that.
No?
He said, oh, you're still masking?
Mm-hmm.
And I said, yeah. And he goes, oh, do you feel more comfortable if I don't wear a mask? I don't care.
Dieter and I had a very casual, calm conversation about it. We even, started talking about, working out with masks.
And so did
and
we.
Stuff.
I said, I don't care. And then he said, oh, it's weird how people get so upset about if you just ask them a simple question.
You seem upset.
Yeah, because you guys are making a big deal about nothing.
Hey, do you want me to wear a mask or not?
Like, yeah. And I said, I don't give a hoot.
Has somebody else been browbeating you about
no,
this behind
the scenes?
No, I do not
care about any of this. I don't know. You guys are idiots. Seriously. It's about everything.
So I'm at a loss right now. I'm not really sure
I keep
what
to
I
myself
did.
Constantly, and you guys are constantly, rat, are you still wearing a mask? It's like, yeah, who cares?
Let
me live
alone.
Eons can't talk to the Doge Father. I got it. Sorry. Sorry, sir. Sorry I bothered you with my conversation at work with a colleague.
That's a conversation,
suck
yeah.
A fat one, you dork.
That's a conversation. You still masking?
Yeah. It's a yes.
That's not a conversation.
The day the goddamn mask thing goes off, it's a normal conversation. When the next half of the sentence is, do you want me to wear one around you?
And I said,
you
I don't care.
Baby.
And I said, I don't care. And you're making a big ass deal
because
about it.
Because you're being a dick.
I said, I don't care. What part of a dick is that, dick?
Holy
God, you're
crap.
An a-hole.
You know what? I'll never say another
good
word.
Good dog. I
want to
hear you.
You bitch.
Who cares?
Go screw yourself.
You're
you
a
freaking
bitch.
Dork. Up
you're so,
yours.
You're so worried about everything. Who cares?
About a.
Yeah, exactly. You make a big deal about every
you
little thing.
You're a sea sucker, dude. Don't ever talk to me again, you punk
wow.
ass bitch.
Wow.
You understand me? Who the hell do you think you are talking to me like that, you punk-ass bitch?
Exactly.
Exactly. Who the hell do you think you are? I'm trying to have a normal conversation with you, and you turn it into this, you punk-ass?
No, I had a normal conversation. I said, I don't care.
You know you didn't. You were acting like a dick.
Because I said, I don't care?
Yeah, you were being a dick.
Okay.
So F you.
Cool.
Punk-ass.
Cool.
She went on Amazon and kind of made out a...
wish list?
Yeah, kind of like a little bit of a, yeah, and said, okay.
Oh, you have the massager?
You're just laughing at it.
Yeah.
Let's see this.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my, yeah.
Shorts on, his work boots. He's ready to go. Good morning, Jeffrey.
Yeah.
Always the showman right
yeah.
there. Yes.
Yes.
Are you wearing your shirt on backwards?
I don't think so. I mean,
I think so.
Oops. No, yeah, I have that shirt. That's oh. backwards. Yeah. The design goes in the front. I mean,
the there you go. Lower scoop yeah, of, see the, how it of the neck.
Shows off your chest pubes now.
Yeah, that looks good. I like it.
So, when I was a little kid, I badly injured my knee in a playground accident at school.
What happened?
What happened was we were just like, me and a couple of kids were playing some, you know, playing a game of football on the playground, you know, during recess. And I tripped and my knee hit this rock that I didn't see. Oh. And it cut the knee. I came this within almost a millimeter of completely severing the tendon in my knee.
Oh.
Yeah, they had to wear a cast for 3 weeks.
They have to cut your knee off if you sever that, right?
No, they were able to say they actually were able to sew it back. They put stitches on the inside, you know, to stitch the tendon.
So now.
And then they put the stitches on the skin, and I had to wear a cast for 3 weeks.
They did a lot of work on you, and now you have special knees.
And when she asked me about giving a shout out on the show, I said I was kind of hesitant, only because I know how Rover is with shout outs of any kind.
How is he?
He doesn't particularly, especially with the birthdays. You know, he says, oh, wait till the birthday shout out show, which we didn't do because of the pandemic.
Is that what he sounds like?
There's a story about this chick. Dude, are you ready for the shizzy?
Do a Snitzer impression.
Yeah. I can't do. Oh, yeah, Hank Hill doesn't work here anymore.
Ooh, that's sexy.
That's actually really good. All right, do it dumb.
You fucking idiot!
Do me.
Oh, let me think. Yeah, I heard that somebody went for bombing for dongs, and yeah, I got a big dong myself, and I'm gonna do some big dick shit this weekend. I got all my Bigfoot files. I saw the Concord last week.
Sounds
I saw
like
the
you.
Concord.
You have 60 seconds now. This is hands-free wiener eating contest, followed by a beer chug. Fastest person, $100, crisp $100 bill. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go.
She's screen grab out. Of that. That's why Duji didn't want to do this. It has nothing to do with the eating of food.
A lot of teeth, huh?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's not going very deep at all. Very shallow.
No, it's slow going.
She's using a lot of teeth.
It's but it's sensual.
She's having a hard time. It's just falling all over the plate now. She's like eating it like a dog. Having to put her face down there. Okay, so she pretty much has, what does she have
left
here?
She has like a quarter of a dog, I would say, maybe a third of a dog.
Just a sliver of the bun left.
Yeah. There we go. A slurp. Just get it in there.
Get it
there
in.
You go.
That's it.
Don't bite it off.
Yeah.
Oh. How do you make this not hot?
Chug, 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 chug. Chug, 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 chug. Okay, I think she got about a tenth of it down.
I'm fine. I love to drink.
Yeah. It's beer o'clock.
Yeah.
Party. Oh, I'm tipsy.
Hey, hat pants.
Peanut. Oh, this makes me have to poop. Anybody else got to poop?
It's already closing time at the bar.
I mean, yes.
What's going on?
She's almost done. Wow, this is the slowest chug ever.
Tilt it back. Tilt your head back. There you go.
Wow. All right. 3 minutes, 7 seconds.
Holy crap.
Go.
There you go. Oh, yeah,
there
he's doing
go.
Good. Okay.
Right,
there
down.
We go. Oh, he's not. Oh, damn.
Oh, this is, he's corn doing a great
cob
job.
Technique.
He's doing a good job. Oh, so far, God. Going much faster than Duji.
I didn't even think of the strategy.
Strange technique. He would have been, if he had his wiener up,
yeah,
he would have been able to chow down much faster than this. He's at a disadvantage, though, because he has a wiener that he can't get up.
Corn,
it's just horizontal.
Corn on the cobinets.
This is
crack that
downfall.
Beer. This is where he's going to have a hard time, you think, Dieter? This
yes.
is his Achilles
well, you know,
heel.
He always says
there we
he
go,
can't chug.
Okay, and you can't puke anything out. Can't spit
go.
Anything out. Don't
here we go.
Spill
no,
any.
Spill
don't spill.
No,
don't try to overdo it. Don't yeah. spill, Jeffrey.
Take
don't.
A break.
Oh,
he says
he's going.
He can never be in a frat because he can't chug. He always says that.
Wow.
All right.
Go. All right, he's got his hands behind his back. Wow, he just deep-throated. He deep-throated three-quarters of the thing, took a huge bite. Now he's chewing. He took that down deep.
Dry.
But like, no gag reflex, though, Rover. It went all the way to the back of his throat.
No, it was like the gay section on Pornhub. He's really...
He's laughing now. He's trying to make jokes about it.
Well, I've never been in that section. Is that what it's like, Rover?
Is he wasting time? He's trying to shotgun.
He's going all over, Rover.
He's trying to shotgun.
Is this legal?
Can he do this? He's shotgunning this beer. Can he beat Jeffrey? There he goes. He's almost got it all the way down. A little bit left, and he stops. He's at 1:21.
Oh, wow.
Go. Oh, wow. He almost got the entire wiener in his mouth. Absolutely. That was a total deep throat of the wiener there. He has only about a quarter of the dog left. He's chewing this. Now, Dieter is an expert. If you've ever seen him eat. He eats like this frequently, where he takes huge bites and then just chipmunk cheeks it. Oh, a little bit of dog left on the plate, a little bit of meat left to slurp down.
Little nugget. He got it.
All right, he got that. All right, go for the beer. He's going for the beer.
God,
he's opening
almost...
the. He is going to go for. Oh, man. He's going for the shotgun.
That was a lot of spillage.
Shotgun method. He has popped it open. He's shotgunning this beer. He's squeezing. He's trying to get the most out. Make sure he gets it all out. All out. A little bit of spillage.
Well, how are the chipmunk cheeks?
Is he. He hasn't swallowed. He hasn't swallowed it all yet.
All right.
With a 2-second penalty.
Because of the spray? Or
because
what?
Of the spray.
Okay.
He comes in at 1:19. The new leader.
Oh, he actually has a new technique. The hot dog is sticking out of the bun. So
circumcised.
And I think he has a bunch of water in his mouth still.
No.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes, he does.
Three.
Yes, he does. Yeah, you are.
Two.
Yeah, you are.
Stop it.
Three.
He won't talk.
Two.
Talk.
One. Go. Wow. Oh my God. He got the whole wiener. Oh, my God. He took the whole wiener. He's got a little bit of bun left. He got the whole wiener down in one. This is incredible.
God.
He's chowing down on the bun.
Spread the bread out. Spread still. He quit.
Lights all over the
place. Well, this still counts. You still have time. Keep going.
It's all wet from Lysol.
I was sweating it. I thought Dom was going to pull that out with that fast start.
All right, Dieter, we do have here a crisp $100 bill for you. Now, if you want.
Sure.
I mean, I could give this to your best friend who just was scammed out of $1,000. I could give it directly to him if you want. Or I can hand it straight to you, Dieter. It's your choice.
He'll lose it. I'll take it.
What are you doing, Dieter?
I did the last one I did was horrible because I had the smallest hole.
100 beer weekend starting right now.
Yeah, so I got to redeem myself.
More after this.
All right, Dieter, now shotgunning another beer. Oh boy, getting a start to the
holiday weekend.
Getting a start to the weekend here.
So fast.
That came out. You just puked.
I just puked.
That's how it goes, though. It's moral day, baby.
That was not beer. That was
that was puke.
That was straight up.
The hot dog just came right back out.
My.
So we went down to a little town called Rogers, Ohio, which is east of Lisbon.
Rogers, Ohio. Population 62.
How far of a drive is that? About an hour and a half, hour and 45 minutes.
Wow.
You must go through gas like I go through water.
Only cost me $3 for the whole trip. Well, unfortunately, when we got there, the damn place was closed. Friday, I didn't catch that right away.
Jeffrey came into my establishment on Saturday night. He didn't do nothing like he said.
Wait a second.
I don't remember being in your establishment Saturday night, Anthony.
What establishments did you go to Saturday night?
I didn't go to any establishment Saturday night, as this guy claims.
In Cuyahoga Falls?
I was not in Cuyahoga Falls Saturday night.
Oh, I don't know.
I was there.
I was not in Cuyahoga Falls Saturday night.
Where? What establishment, Anthony?
It's called The Works.
Mm-hmm. You ever been to The Works, Jeffrey?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wait. Oh, no, thanks. He said you weren't going to call in, you lying sack of crap.
He was there with some girl, and it's just so obvious that it just... She's just hanging out with him for an attention grab.
Who is the girl?
I thought you said it was on the way back.
Who is the girl with your wife and son?
Not going to say her name on the air.
They didn't really do too much. They just had a couple beers. But I had a game card with some extra, you know, you play the games, you get tokens, and I had some tokens on. I said, here, you can give this some Tomas, get him a gift or something. He said, how much money's on here? and then he said, maybe I'll use it another day. And then he just left.
Oh, did he keep it?
He kept it.
I guess he kept it.
Now, Cuyahoga Falls
does not go through Cuyahoga Falls whatsoever.
At all. No. At all.
No.
So it wasn't just on the way. This isn't some plan he just had.
So he purposely routed to Cuyahoga Falls.
That's a baller move to try to go pick up chicks
with your wife and son with you, and you have to leave them in the car.
And then some guy hands you tokens to play, and then you just take them and leave. Say, I'll come back later when my kids aren't here.
Getting into some real. Oh fuck!
Oh, hell yeah! The leather. Dunn's ass ate away at the leather so much. And now there's like exposed actual fabric. I sent you one more. You got Jay-Z's brand.
Oh, Almande Brignac.
And then one more. This is Japanese.
Oh, nice try. Nice fucking try. I suck your own dick while you're at it.
What's the name of it?
What does it say?
Oh, I'll tell you the supposed pronunciation. Give me a hot second.
Uh-huh. While he's looking that up, we'll get
it. It says, sucky my dick. Yeah, hey, Charlie, go suck your own dick while you're at it, pal.
You were going to say it to everybody else, though. It wouldn't have been bad.
Dumbass. How?
What the hell is that?
Kind of sounds like Jeffrey's pants.
Suck my
dick.
Oh, he's got the.
Suck my dick.
What are you doing?
Suck my dick.
He Facebook message called me.
First with my daughter, it was an emergency one because they were gonna they were dicking around for 17 hours. The umbilical was kind of wrapped for some reason, was wrapped around her ankle, and the medical director said she saw that she was under duress, and they said we need to get her into OR now and do a C-section. When my son came along, that was a scheduled C-section.
Is your wife from that area?
Pardon me, Snitz?
Is your wife from that area that you had your babies?
What's he saying?
Is she from that area?
I don't get it.
Oh, my God. What an idiot.
I know. I'm sorry, Snitz, but you talk so quiet. I can't.
Yeah, that was real quiet.
Anywho.
Forget it, man.
Is she from that area?
Thank you. So.
She can't even hear you.
Who listens to AM radio?
Oh, you ever try to listen to that?
Oh, my God. You can't understand anything. It's so muffled.
It sounds like a World War II bomb is dropping in the background. I listened last week. The whole time it goes.
It's the ratings.
No, that's his Snitcher is too fast.
No, I've never. I don't think I ever had dyslexia, or have ever been treated for, or even been diagnosed for it.
So you've never had any instances.
I've never had any kind of diagnosis, except the fact that of what I was labeled when I was a kid. I won't say the word on the air because
RME.
It's not politically correct.
EMR.
No, RME.
REM.
Yeah.
What?
God, these idiots in here.
I think they have EMR.
God. He's talking about being dyslexic, you idiots.
What?
They don't know what dyslexia even is.
Still don't know. You have to explain it.
Dieter,
I think I dismissed what you said.
I was
yeah,
diagnosed. I said RME.
Okay.
I don't get what is.
Get it?
No.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God.
But he was EMR. That was his diagnosis.
But he ran it.
I am 45. She is 32. Got to turn that microphone on.
It's on. He wasn't speaking.
It was on, but he was. Okay.
45 and she's 32.
That's
I'd say. I don't know, 16?
I think I might have done something I might regret down the road.
What?
I was so inspired, and I love Jeffrey so much.
Best friends?
He is my best friend, my true best friend. I don't know, I might regret this, but hey, YOLO. Jeffrey, check this out.
Whoa!
Put your glasses on.
What the hell?
Wow.
I had to do it.
I also got a JLR.
Whoa!
Yikes.
And a heart tattoo.
How much? I wonder if those were fake tattoos. The ones that can scrub them off when you're done.
Oh, no. This fake. I'll tell you what wasn't fake is the pain. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Look at this.
I got one myself, too.
Wait a second. Doug got one on his.
In honor of the butt buddies. I also.
Wait a second.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, baby.
On your ass.
Let me come over here.
Being blind would suck. This would be a tough one.
Charlie's just figuring out now. Being blind would suck.
You want to be blind?
But I've never tried. No, I don't think anybody wants to be. I'm just saying.
All right, so let me open both of these bags.
Just in case you guys didn't know. I look at every Dorito.
Open your mouth.
Open your mouth.
Okay. That's chip number one.
Okay.
Number two.
Those are both really good. I'm going to say the second one's a smaller bag.
You are incorrect. All right, that's Dorito number one.
Okay, really nice. Man, these are good. This is not even... This is a small bag. No doubt about it. This is garbage.
That you believe is a small bag.
Yeah. This is... Ugh. There's something in this one that's totally different.
You want another one?
Give me another one, and I'll tell you if that was the...
Put your head down.
Because I'm telling you, those two were different, and I'll tell you which one is one or two again.
Showing the camera which one we're going to do. Okay. And I am going to give you another chip here.
That's the same as the first one. No
same
doubt.
Same as
mind.
The first one. So you say the first one and the third one are the same.
Do a test so people know I can't see. Like, try to, when I'm not, like, make, try to make me flinch or something. Like,
God, Robert.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Jeez,
Charlie.
What
the hell was that? It was a half full bottle of water.
Yeah,
I'm going to have
a big
ass
bruise. Yeah, but
when
you don't expect that,
you hit me right with the lid.
In the eye.
Where'd that hit you?
God, I'm going to have a big ass bruise, you dickhead. And
you said to do it.
I'm about to go on vacation. Damn you.
Oh, man. Dumb, where'd it hit you, right?
Right in my forehead. Literally like a billboard. Hey, everybody, look at this big ass lump I'm going to have.
But dumb. Point proven.
Dude, that's really heavy.
We got a nice, beautiful painting, an art piece of artwork for us.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You have a picture of that? Can we see this? Are you naked with a huge penis on it or something?
No. Hold on.
Did she like it or was she like...
No, she cried over it. It's a beautiful gift.
Who painted it?
Somebody on Fiverr. I just paid somebody on Fiverr. Fiverr's not $5 anymore. That's the scam of the website. Everything is...
That's where you went thinking it was going to cost you $5.
And then to get that printed out, because, you know, that person painted it, and then they send you a digital artwork of it. And then you got to get printed out. No, money starts adding up there with a painting. You know, it doesn't really look like me because I didn't pay a lot. I kind of look like a woman, but it's the...
Oh, my God, she cried.
The lesbian couple.
I sent her the Sleepy Time Tea Bear, and I said, hey, throw us in there. And then she sent it back, and I didn't know how to tell her, like, this kind of sucks. Because you could do revisions. So, like, I was able to say, like, well, I don't like the shirt color or something, or my socks are the wrong color. You're allowed to revise that, but I don't know how to say, like...
I look like a woman?
You're a man? Suck.
All right, so there's the bear.
Charlie.
Okay, all right.
Oh, Charlie, this is a great gift where... Duji, I'm sorry that you had a lonely birthday with dance moms that ended at 6 p.m. I had a beautiful anniversary. And then that's the updated one.
Is it even the same couch? Oh, yeah, I guess it's green.
It's close enough.
You got to get two people on the couch yet.
Yeah.
Bring in your glasses. Goggles. Let me see them real quick. Let me give them a shot here. Let's see how these...
work.
Oh, my God.
Oh, oh my. Sweet.
Oh, my God, dude.
You look very
thick.
Wow. They, whoa.
You look very special, Rover.
Right now, you can go back in time. And the day you met her, you can change that day and not pass her on the street when her nipples lactated.
She started lactating.
So you don't come out of your house that day.
I don't know. I mean, honestly, if I probably would have married somebody else.
Okay.
But you know what? Here's the way I see it.
Uh-huh.
I played the hand that was dealt to me, so it's...
Oh, you're playing.
Sorry. It's... It is what it is, my friend.
You're going to cut your own hand
this
off.
Is a good idea.
Oh, wow. Stupid.
Oh, this is not as sharp.
This is not sharp at all.
Okay. All right, here we go.
Ooh!
Ooh! Oh, that cuts the microphone. Yes. It just cut the thing on the microphone.
Yeah, it did, yeah. Cord, yeah!
Oh, it just cut the microphone.
Cut a rubber band. Wow.
Okay. Can you see that?
Yeah, we're moving. Right. Who cares?
What do you think? Is it going to work on first try?
Yeah, no. So. With that sword?
I think you got it.
It'll break right through it.
I think lay it flatter, Rover. A little bit more flat.
Oh!
No, the champagne bottle, I mean.
Bounced off.
Oh, yes!
Nice! Two of them. You got it.
Second try.
Oh, that's one.
I think that's because of the way Dumb told you to hold it.
The whole wine glass just shattered.
Wow. That's wine glass.
Is Dumb going to open a bottle of beer this week?
See if it works.
All right, here it is.
Find the seam.
Find the seam.
You got it.
Oh, you got it. Whoa!
No.
Again.
Oh, tilt it more. Tilt the sword.
Hard with two people.
Have Jeffrey stand behind you and put his arms around you.
Oh, yeah, like a bowling. Like if you're showing somebody how to bowl.
It's all in the
hips. It's all in the wrist.
It's all in the hips.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Come on, get angry. Come on. Yeah.
You don't need to put a lot of force. Just slide it all the way up.
Tilt the...
Oh!
You're almost there. A little more power.
Yeah!
Are you able to do a cartwheel here, or would his little legs hit the lights up there if he's doing a cartwheel?
Oh, no, he'll be fine. There's plenty of room.
Well, let me give it a shot, Doug.
All right.
Hey, Snitz, fire up the hallway camera.
Okay.
Got that, Snitz?
Yeah, you got that, director? Yeah. Taking cues from LaRoque here.
Slow blow.
He took all his... Took off the medallion.
I was going to say it's going to hit him in the face.
Don't want to break that. Okay, here he goes. He's out in the hallway.
Oh, God.
Oh! You okay?
I think he just injured himself.
Now, somebody's saying that this is definitely your son, Jeffrey, in the middle.
I think so, too.
And you don't know your own son.
Yep. Agreed.
Yeah, I don't think it looks like him.
I think it's him because of the strap on the back.
Go zoom in on the back of... the middle person's head.
Mm-hmm. It's Tomash.
Does
that's
Richard
son,
have glasses with a strap on the
yeah,
back?
Yeah, that's my son. Yeah, that's me, my daughter, my son at the concession stand.
How do you even know it's your own son? It's a flaming shot, and he spills it on the birthday girl.
If you own a bar, you shouldn't allow this.
I agree.
But it looks cool. That's why they do it.
Some hot bush.
This is in Japan.
Chick is smoking.
Literally.
Got anyone else?
Like a real bush fire.
Yeah, real pussy fire.
Gives a new term to pussy fire.
God.
Fire crotch?
Yeah. Hey, who knows?
Okay.
Fire to pussy.
Fire in the hole?
Fire in the hole.
Literally.
Nothing else.
Nothing.
Nothing else.
Nothing else?
Nothing else.
You sure nothing else?
For real, though?
I mean, just think about this. Is there anything?
Friday, Geneva and Lake. Saturday, diner.
Sunday, wrestling practice.
Nothing else.
That's it. That's it in its entirety. Nothing else worth mentioning.
No, nothing else worth mentioning.
What about this? Where are you?
What the hell is this?
So, Charlie, you had another question for me.
I have another
question.
So it's just you and two chicks, huh?
Yeah, why not?
Well, why not? Can you explain this? What is this?
Yeah, I was changing into that pair of shorts that the girl loaned me so I could, you know, jump in the water.
Oh.
Just right in front of the two girls.
Oh, yeah.
Why? No, they hid their eyes.
Oh, what? Yeah,
they have a camera! How
they took the picture then?
I had no idea. Well, there's going to be some... Well, I'll tell you right now, there's going to be some unfriending going on here.
Uh-oh. Go, read it.
Oh, it's Spanish. I came... pronounce half the words on the...
Let's just try. Just read it. Read the paragraph.
Trying mine to... I couldn't... believe that I caught a top...
Sounds more German.
You had like an accent all of a sudden.
I'll sit today on the chart what I was reading. The phenomenal... The phenomenal power of the human. Oh, wait. If you can't read this, you have a strong mind to. I couldn't believe that I could really understand what I was reading. The phenomenal power of the human mind, according to a research at Cambridge University. It doesn't matter in what order the letters are in a word are. The only important thing is that the first and last letter be in the right place. The rest can be a total mess and you can still read it without a problem.
Well, that's what I'm going to do. Next time I need a diagnosis, I'm just going to get on TikTok.
Okay.
Hey, everyone. I need a diagnosis.
Like a lot of times you'd be selling wolf tickets. And people that have been locked up, like...
What's a wolf ticket? Like, I don't know what a wolf ticket is. Like,
my bad. So it's like if you're sitting there always beating your chest, like, I'm going to beat this guy, I'll bash this guy's head in, da-da-da-da.
I don't do that.
But you never do it. You threaten to beat up Rover, right?
And Dieter had to hold the door closed because I was going to murder him. Well, Dieter had to hold the door shut.
I keep saying everyone's about to be murdered, but you never... Nothing...
Dieter's 250 pounds holding the fucking door shut.
Threaten Rob?
Yes, I did. You want to know why? Because he pissed me off.
Again.
And guess what?
It's not about the threat. It's not saying you can't threaten, but that's why people don't believe it. Like, that's why people want to fight you, because you're always selling wolf tickets. Dog, I'm trying to tell you, if you do this to the wrong person, you're going to get put to sleep.
Do what to the wrong person? Do what?
Didn't you just say you had an argument with somebody about Uber or something? You were going to pull him out of his car and strangle him if something else didn't
happen? I was.
There's going to be consequences.
Hi, you're on the aftermath.
Hey, guys, did I win the wolf tickets?
hey, at least it's alive, though, you know?
Yeah, at least I know I can still go to the bathroom and...
Well, you don't need a boner to go to the bathroom.
That's true.
Well, unless you're talking about going pee-pee in a girl's puss-puss. Is that what you're talking
about? I'd
rather
go pee-pee in my wife's puss, thank you very much.
Okay, all right, that's good.
I would prefer that.
This is an adult.
I was having...
Librarian.
Librarian? Yeah. You think so?
I think.
Researcher, perhaps? You know, a biologist or something? That's what I'm going to guess. Looks very smart.
Yeah.
Glasses just make people look smart, don't they?
Especially on chicks.
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
It's too late.
No, Duji.
Wait, what?
Doesn't
Brittany moved out on Saturday.
What?
Yeah, so I'm not really ready to talk about it yet.
Our iHeartRadio Music Festival is, I'm getting...
I didn't catch it on camera, but I thought.
Lower and lower. Yes, my seat is just going, about every 10 or 15 seconds, it's just going down. Maybe it's stopped now.
I saw it.
There it is.
You're like an old man shrinking as he gets older. You're going lower and lower. Jeez.
Today's my last day with the company.
Wow.
Today is your last day.
This is it.
I said it. Is he moving on?
What are you talking about?
This is it. I've just had a lot of stuff going on, like outside of the radio station, good stuff. DJing's been going really good lately.
Now, wait a second. Did you tell people this?
I told Jason, the PD.
How
that
long
was
ago?
2 weeks ago.
They don't tell us? This is the weirdest thing. Are
Jason?
You serious?
Should Jason tell us?
Yeah, I find that insane that they...
A member of our show is leaving and they don't tell us.
Yeah, it's very strange.
Hey, you wanted the reaction on air. This is what you get.
Yeah, we got it.
Oh, yeah! Oh,
what the
Who
hell
the hell is this?
Well, I'll be damned. If it isn't Ace Maverick right here before my very eyes. Oh, yeah. This is your half of the Ace Maverick t-shirt sales profits. $1 million. Oh, yeah. You ready for that money, Ace Maverick?
If there's actually $1 million in that
there
briefcase.
There is actually $1 million in this briefcase, buddy boy. And I gotta tell you, now that I'm seeing you here in the putrid, stinking flesh, I ain't impressed.
Is that right?
Yeah, you know, you might think you're the top gun, but in my eyes, you ain't nothing but an ace hole. Oh, yeah! You think you're flying high at cruising altitude, but comparatively speaking, next to the macho man, you're garbage. You want to get this case full of $1 million? Well, I'll tell you what, the only case you're getting is a case of bad breath and diarrhea, yeah. As long as I'm still standing, like Elton John used to say, you ain't getting to this case unless you get through me, buddy boy. You need a little TLC, tables, ladders, and chairs. We forgot the table and the chair.
Ace is taking off his flight suit.
But we got a ladder, buddy boy. You want this briefcase?
I mean, this
come
is,
and get this briefcase,
a
buddy boy.
Briefcase is hanging from the ceiling in Studio RMG. You better come and get Ace Maverick. Just hit Randy Macho Man Savage with a garbage can. Elbow drop!
It's
Maverick! Oh my god, look at this! Ace is elbowing! Oh my god! Just slammed! He's got a falling chair! He just took a folding chair and is slamming a Randy Macho Man Savage over the head with it. Oh, now he's
I don't know what the
figure four
is.
Over.
Oh no,
figure four. Oh
no,
can he lock it in? Oh, Ace Maverick doing a figure four on Randy Macho Man Savage. Oh, is Macho Man gonna tap out?
I give up!
He's tapping out. He's
locking in. Referee! Oh, his ass is out!
Oh, elbow drop right onto the kid, right into the kidney there. Oh no! What does Ace have to do? And oh, Ace is getting up on the ladder. He just took the briefcase now.
You ain't seen the last of me, Ace Maverick. You son of a bitch.
Macho Man Savage has
oh, he's going
left.
After him!
Outside the ring! Ace is chasing Macho Man away! Ace is chasing him! They're in the he just ripped the belt! He just ripped the belt from Macho Man Savage now literally crawling down the hallway. Ace Maverick stripped him of the belt. Unpack what just happened there.
He does not understand this.
What?
It's the NWA World's Heavyweight Champion. A belt held by legends. The Briscoes. Harley Race. Terry Funk. Dory Funk Jr. Ric Flair. Nick Aldis.
Does anyone here sleep naked?
No, I sleep in boxer briefs.
Okay, Dieter?
Yeah, same thing, my boxers.
Sometimes I sleep topless.
Topless?
Look how many.
Oh my gosh. How many ceiling fans?
Look at this.
But there's only one wired.
Yeah, only one's wired. They're all simultaneously going off. A 1, 2, 3, 4. There's a couple more.
Five.
How many are down there? 10?
Yeah,
just.
Know.
Look at the haphazard wiring going on here.
Oh, my God. How does your house not just take off?
Charlie, sorry about the interruption, but I may have to bail because I got to take I got a bathroom emergency.
What do you have?
Oh, wait. I got to take a shit. Pull some shit.
If you could just check your voicemail, please.
Hey, what's going on? Hello? Jeffrey?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why did you call the hotline?
Don't ask me, motherfucker.
No, you were supposed to call your voicemail.
Yeah, but you called the hotline. Hello? Why are you calling in the hotline?
Oh.
You're the shit sharer.
Here you go.
Oh,
gosh.
Where's the wipe?
Yeah, where is the toilet? I had to try to make it as fast as I can because I got a little bit of shit on my wrist, but I was able to wash it off.
Oh, my God.
What?
Hey, shit happens, dude.
No, that doesn't happen.
Okay, right, so where's the phone?
Oh, so let me ask you something. Since how far are your pants pulled down?
Where
when
does
you're wiping
the phone
your
go while you're wiping?
Ooh.
Oh, that's
so
a good
quickly.
Question.
My pants are at my ankles.
No, where's your phone?
Where's your phone?
My phone's in my pocket.
How does it get in the pocket when they're on the floor?
Are you stupid or something? My,
no,
my phone
I think
is in
you
my
are,
pocket
and your story's falling apart. He didn't wipe.
Oh, no, come on.
Nope.
I think he wiped. He got crap on his hand.
Okay. All right, there you are on the toilet. Phone is, you have your phone in your hand. You get it out of your pocket. Your pants are around the ankles. Then you stand up.
I hope somebody walks by right
turns
now.
Turns around, takes a photo, puts the phone back
now
in his pocket.
Wiping. You didn't wipe, Jeffrey.
I used to go on the route with my boyfriend. It's pretty sexy seeing him all strong arm.
Do you ever give him road age while he's driving?
No. No. And then he actually inspired me to get a job on the short.
On the what?
On the smaller bus.
On the
short bus. You'd be the perfect driver for the short bus.
He just picked. You were just getting picked up by that. You weren't working there. All those guys think they work there.
They pull up to the bus stop and they're like, "Oh, this poor mongoloid with the huge head, hydrocephalic Duji gets on the short bus."
They won't even give you another game.
No. That's what Krista went in to do.
Not the Spider-Man game, just another game.
No, she said no. We just won't accept. We just won't accept this.
I think because maybe it's under your credit card. That makes sense. Ooh, on that return.
Yeah, that might. That could be.
It's not her.
Yeah, that was that good answer. No one.
Ever since
you
became a GameStop owner, you're no longer a fucking gamer.
No wonder
you're a CEO. You're thinking like a dumbass.
He's the man.
Daddy Warbucks over here, Mr. Big Spender.
Doge Father.
Yeah, the Doge Father spending big bucks. Oh, I'm the owner of GameStop. Go fuck yourself, Snitzer. You wouldn't say this about yourself. If this is what you were going through, you wouldn't. But all of a sudden, now you're Mr. Corporate. Snitzer, I got to be honest, for your hippie past and Mr. Vegan, you're also Mr. fucking Corporate now. Sit on it, dick.
Of course, it was one of those things where we... you know, had to drag out of them. You guys all go out. And then at the end of the night, everyone goes home. But you go over to the neighbor's house and spend the night over there.
I did not spend the night. And Jeffrey did lie about this, too, because he didn't want it to get out that night. Valerie was up. So we did get Taco Bell that night. Jeffrey went right to bed because he had to be on the show in the morning. And we went over to his name is Nick. Very nice guy. We went over there on the porch to eat, and Valerie was up, and she came with me to eat, and then she asked if she could come stay at my house, so I had her here for a couple of days.
Oh, a couple of days?
Yeah. Took her to the arcade at Geneva on the Lake. Yeah.
Oh,
Jeffrey didn't want you guys to know.
Did they have a sink, Jeffrey?
Oh, my God.
What?
What
imagine,
happened?
Imagine driving 2 hours, and this is what you get to.
Oh, my Lord. Are you kidding me?
Jeffrey, you didn't. That's not
Stop
even
it.
Open.
That's the place you went to?
Is
you
it open?
You want a 7-and-7? Go out to the soda machine outside and get it.
I wear like a 34-30, 34 in the waist, 30 length.
Like he said, Jeffrey's a pretty thin
He's
guy
tiny,
for the most part. He's got a little bit of a gut, though.
What was the inseam?
My inseam was 30.
30 nuts in your mouth.
F you.
I think I farted on you, too.
What?
He just said, I farted on you.
Yeah, guy's just coming in here blasting Arby's farts all day.
He was adjusting his pants. I thought something was
happening. Don't distract him. You guys are distracting
I'm
him.
I'm not. I'm just doing
Oh! Did you see him push that? Scott! Was that real?
Jeffrey farted into Dumb's face, and Dumb is going to try to guess what Jeffrey had to eat last night. What do you have? Open this envelope up, Jeffrey. Dumb guessed Arby's after smelling this rancid fart.
Amazingly, Dumb is correct.
What? No!
What?
Stop it!
Are you serious?
No!
I knew it. I knew he could sniff fart.
Stop it!
Certified fart sniffer, baby!
Jeffrey, for a long time, I've wanted to visit all seven continents. And I said, you know what? I'm going to set that as a goal over the next 5 years. South America. I've got to get to Africa.
Antarctica. Ooh.
I've got to get to Australia.
And you want to take somebody who's incontinent.
I thought eventually it would come eat the
chicken.
They're
pretty skittish.
Yeah, there's two of them. I'm like, man, if I could just somehow train them to always come to my yard and feed them, how sweet would that be?
I just saw a fox. Cool. I see a fox probably once a month out by my
Oh, really?
Body. Yeah.
Oh, no. This is.
I saw a coyote driving home the other day.
You sure it wasn't a dog?
Nah, this was a coyote.
What was it driving?
Wait, I was waiting for it. I was just waiting for
Dad
it.
Joke.
Wow. When is it going to happen? What's he driving? Where is he going?
I saw a coyote driving yesterday.
What's a coyote? Animal? I don't get it. Is it a person?
No.
Oh, wow.
Oh, God.
Oh, wow. Dad joke over the head.
What's a dad joke? So there's no
Snitzer's
one that doesn't
dad
get it?
Joke. I saw a coyote driving the other day, and he said, what was it driving? Ba-dum-bump.
It's a terrible joke because I still don't get it.
Oh, my God. The wording.
I was the one driving, right? The joke is, what was the coyote
She
driving?
Actually heard it as, you also saw a coyote driving.
It's really a grammar joke. A minor in English would pick that up pretty quick.
Well, happy birthday, no. Jeffrey. I hope you're happy. Oh, come on. It's Dump just dancing around wearing nothing. He's completely naked.
This is what you wished for on your birthday?
Oh, no.
Dumb, you dropped your pen, Dumb.
Oh, thanks for that.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no. He's smearing his ass cheeks.
Oh, I love it.
In the brown paint. He's going to try and leave a perfect ass print impression right on his canvas. Let's see how it works. Okay. Now you don't want to sit too hard and break the canvas. He's putting the brush between his ass cheeks.
Oh.
He's putting the brush between his ass cheeks. Can he get all the way...
That looks deep.
Oh, no.
Oh,
Dumb,
my God.
Dumb cut off
Are
a finger of a rubber glove,
me?
And he's putting that on the handle of the paintbrush,
like
of
a
the
condom?
Foam brush. Like a condom. That's right.
For what?
Oh, I think I have. Oh, no.
Why do you need
no.
that?
Oh, what? No. Oh, no. Oh, what is he? Oh, he's lubing it up in his mouth.
If that slips any further up his poop chute, he's going to have a bad case of toxic shock syndrome. That's what's going to happen.
Okay.
And that's the reality
this is
of
beautiful.
It.
Beautiful. Oh, no. Second brush?
Oh, my God. He's Oh, no.
Not a second brush. He's looping up a second brush.
Oh, he's tucked the paintbrush between his legs. It's now up front. Here's,
no, on the left
look,
side.
Here's eye, nose,
oh my
mouth,
God.
Hair. The face of Jesus clearly appears.
Holy crap. Okay, now this is a woman's head, I would say, so far. With some hair. It's got, the Karen. It's got the Karen haircut.
Oh wow. Just one of those. Wow, an artist's canvas flip.
All right. This is
really defined. Those, beautiful, beautiful brown. Beautiful brown eye.
This is.
I mean, the realism is fantastic.
Is that Toddy
Can
Ruxton?
You move your head to the left, sir? So we could get, so we could see
Jeffrey,
it.
Move.
Move your head to the left. There we go. Do you want to sell it, or do you want me to put a hole in it so you could fuck it?
Neither.
Gape ape.
The gape ape.
After my divorce, before my divorce, I never really cried at all. But then, you know, also you start thinking about letting your kids down and stuff. I don't know, maybe that's why Dumb versus, like, your guys' whole crew, since other than Snitzer
Could be
has
true.
Kids,
Snitzer has kids. He cries a lot. Dumb has kids. He cries
what about
a lot.
Jeffrey?
So maybe.
Kids? I forgot. He's here.
He never cries.
Yeah.
Was he asleep out there? What was he doing? I saw his head in his hand. Were you asleep?
He was crying.
No, I was just waiting to be invited into the conversation.
Oh, okay. All right. You volunteer every other time.
Well, no, it's because every time I try to
wait.
Get involved in a conversation, sometimes I wind up saying something.
All right, we'll be right back. Hang on. So what'd she do?
Wax and shape.
Why didn't you just tell us the truth?
I am.
No,
I said she waxed and shaped them.
So
did you tip?
Of course I tipped it. Actually, the total was $25, and I added a $7 tip to make it an even 30.
Wait, you added...
This is wild. Now, if you're not familiar with this area...
Oh, he's farting.
Was that what that was? I heard a pop.
Wow.
That was wet.
Oh, he's crapping his pants.
If you can prove you did not crap your pants right now, I will give you $50.
And if he did crap his pants, he doesn't owe you anything.
Doesn't owe anything because he's already having a pretty bad day.
For $50, will you prove to him that you didn't crap your pants?
So as we were finishing
he crapped his pants.
No, Jeffrey, we warned you over and over again. You're going to play in this dangerous game. And you lost, finally. You tried to distract the conversation with your fart. You crapped your pants. And now you want to get back to the conversation. Hey, ask me about the wedding where I cheated on my wife.
About this weird drive.
Go to the bathroom, please.
Oh no!
Oh, he's walking kind of.
Oh no, he's not gonna. He's not gonna sit down, is he?
He can't.
He won't sit down.
He can't sit down.
Uh
oh! Oh no!
Oh! If you could prove, if you show me your undies and there's not crap in it,
I ain't falling for this yet, dude.
There's no falling for it. It's $50. Shake, right here.
This prove it. Rub his face in it, Jeffrey. $50. You get that free $50.
My colleague Michael here, he's going to grab one side of your pants, and I'll grab the other one, sir, if you're okay with us touching you. Sir? Oh, sorry. If you could.
He's cake! He's cake! He's totally cake!
Oh, God, dude. Jeffrey, you have to go to the bathroom and wash yourself, please.
Did he? Okay, what? Explain what? Did he crap himself?
Or is that all? Completely filled. Completely filled. Top to bottom, completely filled.
Fresh.
Oh, yeah.
So he crapped himself.
He crapped himself.
And finally, actor Jeremy Piven, your favorite. Mm. He was recently the victim of a home burglary where thieves broke in and they got away with $20,000 worth of clothing.
Clothing? Oh, that's... Boy, they didn't make
out. I don't think you could get $20 worth of clothing.
Will they ever be able to wash out the stench of asshole from all those clothes?
Oh. Whoa.
That's the shizzy.
No, I didn't... What?
The skid marks of the spiller.
Good job.
Yes.
That was amazing.
Jeffrey, are you impressed?
Boo.
Hold on. Hello?
Boo.
No.
Someone said that dumb sounds... crazy for having those thoughts of wanting to kill someone, and they wonder, dumb, if mental illness.
Stop! I don't have thoughts about wanting to kill someone. Who said that?
This guy. This guy. I'm just telling you a text message.
I don't know who said that though.
I don't know. It's a random phone number. I don't know the guy.
I don't understand how this moron took that from anything I've just said here.
He thinks you
don't
have...
want to kill anyone. I don't lay around thinking about it.
That you
who
have
cares what he believes. He's wrong.
Mental illness Ooh. That runs in your family, oh. and he's wondering if that's the case.
Oh. I don't really give a rat's ass what he thinks because that's not what I said. I don't walk around thinking that way. So,
oh, Pop Tart. Oh, that's
hell
good.
Yeah.
Can't
eat the whole bottle.
Oh, my God.
Pop Tarts. Dumb said he cannot resist Pop Tarts.
You're happy when you're fatter. Front of him.
He has to eat the whole Duji brought him in a box of Pop Tarts.
Yes.
Wow.
Go to school. Oh, blueberry, too. Oh.
Go to town, man.
Oh, yes. Wow, look at the mood swing, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
Food, he eats his feelings.
Crying. How many come in a box?
Oh, my God.
12 in the big box. Baby.
I thought that was six.
I thought it was six. Oh,
six
my
pack,
God.
12 pastries.
Oh, my God.
Oh, dumb,
you
I'm
ate
sorry.
In that commercial break, you ate all the entire box. Oh, my God. Are you serious?
Oh my God.
Well, hold on.
Yes?
Breaking... Luke Bryan just contacted me.
Oh, no.
No, he did not.
Oh, no.
Yes,
what did he
did.
Say?
He said, you got to play this song. He said he made a song in honor of Dumb.
It don't matter what plans you got for lunch break, no. Yeah, I can order you Uber Eats Wendy's with the biggie fries. And I don't mind if you got other guys trying to feed you.
Cause I'll just find out where they live and set their houses on fire. Girlie, come home, oh, I'm cranking my hog to your pictures. I swear if you let me get one more plow, I'll overdraft my dang bank account. If you wanna bang, smoke weed, and argue, I'm literally never ever busy. You can make me stop playing Fortnite, I'll pass you the bone just like old times. I wanna fly up around while you moan and you grunt. Swing on by, I'll roll you a blunt. We can have sex, then get in a fight. Then I'll take all your clothes and I'll throw them back outside.
Dumb, are you impressed?
Well, I don't know who that song was about because I'm not lazy and I don't play Fortnite and I am busy constantly, so that's great. Awesome. It's about somebody else.
Tweeted something.
His eyebrows waxed.
I'm just looking right now that really you brought that up, and there is something going on there. There is something going on.
Oh my God.
Take that hat off.
Somebody said,
take this hat off.
So Tomas Aaron tweeted something along the lines of, like, my dad got his eyebrows done and he looks like a clown.
That means he's the best in the world in 2018.
Yep.
The best in the world.
Uh-huh.
Huge deal.
How many Mr. Olympians can you name?
All of them.
You can?
You want me to go to the beginning?
Yeah. I don't think I know. I assume.
Well, I'm going to go to 65.
Arnold is one, right?
He won seven of them, actually.
Oh, okay.
So, okay, let's see if I can get this. 65 and 66, first guy was Larry Scott. Okay?
Hold on, I gotta look at it.
Okay, yes.
Sergio Oliveira was 67, 68, and 69. 70 is when Schwarzenegger started. 70 to 75 was Schwarzenegger, okay?
Yeah.
Franco Colombo in 76, 78. Wait, that was 77, 78, 79, Frank Zane. 80, Schwarzenegger came back. Huge upset in 1980 because he was doing movies. Then he just jumped into competition in Africa, and he won. And people were pissed. There were fights backstage. Mike Metzger trying to fight Schwarzenegger going, how the hell could you jump in this competition? Barely even trained and won the whole freaking world title. Now, 80 to 83 is kind of weird because there's a bunch of different names like Eric Dickerson, Samir.
Eric Dickerson?
There's a Dickerson in there.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, all right. Yeah,
Samir Banu and Franco Colombo won again. Lee Haney then took over in the 80s. He won from like 84 to early 90s.
Okay.
Then Dorian Yates took over.
Oh my God.
He was in the 90s. 90
Theater's just doing this right out of his.
Yeah. Then Ronnie Coleman took over, who they say is the best of all time. 98 to 2005, Ronnie Coleman, he is the most with eight, tied with Lee Haney. 2005, Jay Cutler won, and 2006.
Uh-huh.
Then, no. 2006 and 7 was Jay Cutler. 2008 was Dexter Jackson.
Oh,
one off, he won. Okay, hold on. Uh-huh. Then Jay Cutler comes back. 2009, 2010, Jay Cutler comes back. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Now, where are we at after him? Then Phil Heath takes over. He wins in all the 2000s, late 2010s. 2018 was Sean Roden. So he won just a one-off. He won. He beat Phil Heath, who was going for number eight to tie the title of eight titles. So 2018, this guy won, which is a huge deal.
Give me 2019 and 2020.
2019 was Brandon Curry, and then 2021 was Big Ramy.
Wait, Snitzer, how long have you been off bread?
For this whole time off.
And why?
I'm trying to lose carbs? Trying to lose some weight. I'm trying to get off carbs.
Why are you feeling chunky?
Yeah.
There's no food left. What can this guy eat?
Vegetables.
Peanut butter.
What happened? You feeling a little chunky?
Well, my whole diet is
He feels fat.
Carbs.
He's getting fat. And
of course.
He feels disgusting. Yeah. He looks disgusting. He's getting older.
Wow, okay.
Well, I am getting older, but still beautiful. Thank you.
You guys are going to call me fat every day, you know.
Well,
the shoe fits.
But I say it back
once. I wasn't fat when I was your age.
I know the feeling of gaining weight. Like, I know what it feels like to gain weight. Like, when you go,
I know this.
I just put on weight. Like, I just got fat. I just got fatter. Like, I would pay money to be bulimic
I'm accidentally bulimic because I eat so much, I just puke. I can't. I'm binging to the point where I purge.
He lays down, and then the food just starts coming up.
I throw up in my mouth all the time.
Yeah, the other night.
What are you talking about? When you lay down, your food doesn't come back up your throat and then throw it up all night long?
Yourself up gagging on your own puke?
That's acid reflux.
No, you don't. You never throw up and then swallow it in your lungs and then end up sitting in a in a tour bus going,
Someone wants a ruling, simp ruling, Charlie. Jake says dumb is 100% a simp. Once he texted, come home, girly, that put him in the simp category.
Simp. That is major simp. Did he text that? Or
have
did
you
he,
ever, do you not know how a gavel is like?
Well, no, it's all, it's.
I know, but you're doing it sideways, too, sometimes. Like, he's doing it on the side.
I know how to gavel.
Okay.
Listen.
He's
been arrested so many times, he knows how it
did
works.
Did he tweet that or text that?
Oh, if he tweeted, that's.
That's super simple.
Yeah.
Hey, Charlie, your style's a little too stiff. Let me show
okay.
you.
Oh, you do it.
That's, all right. All right,
three. How about three of them? Boom, boom, boom.
Okay, here, I'll show it. Go like this. You go like.
Okay.
Wow.
There you go.
There's three. Get on.
When did the show start? 2003?
2003.
Yeah. Plus 25?
That would be 28 years.
Yep. 2028.
Well, hold on. Jeffrey, you give us the answer.
No.
2003
okay.
plus 25 years.
I would be 20. Give me a.
Yeah.
About 2026, 27?
Exactly.
2026,
27? Nailed it.
Oh, shit, dude.
What do you think of that?
Whatever, pal.
Oh, that's it. Fucking great.
NWO is a wrestling faction. The NWA is a governing body of professional wrestling. It means National Wrestling Alliance. In the old days, the whole profession was all divided into like, all kinds of territories around the country.
I'm sorry, guys.
Every
Stop
promoter
you.
Had
I apologize.
Their territory, and what they would do is they would get together and share their talent, and
I'm
each
really
each wrestler
I know.
Would
I know
bounce
why.
Between
I'm
bounce
sorry.
Between
yes.
territories to try to make a name for themselves.
Maybe we don't.
Well, whoever
have
the NWA
show.
Heavyweight mm-hmm. champion was at that time, we'll say like guys like the Briscoes.
Normal conversation
yeah.
underneath.
Yeah, and they would just pretend like there's nothing going on.
Oh,
I was very interested.
That was good. I mean,
see where this goes.
You start over again?
No. So, I was getting to the point where when you're the NWA champion.
Listen, go do whatever. I heard you getting into your truck or whatever it sounded
locking
like.
A girl
so,
there.
Derek, I appreciate it.
No. What was that little comment? What was that?
What's up?
Snide comment you
What's
made
up? About I can't hear you.
What was that?
I'm sorry. Yeah, what was that, Charlie? Yeah, sure did you say something, Charlie?
I don't think so.
Charlie.
I think, Charlie.
Yeah, it's easy. You know, it's easy to talk. You know, it's easy to talk when I'm not there. But if I was
well,
there.
You're still here.
Well, I'm sure he wouldn't say what he said, you know.
I said you were locking a child in your
car.
That was the joke I made. Because you're a convicted pedophile? That's what I said.
Yeah, it's really easy for you to talk shit over the phone.
No, I'm just saying. You said I wouldn't say it. I wanted to repeat it a little louder.
Oh, wow. All right. Now
this guy's a little grumpy.
Well, what a fucking piece of shit. I just slapped the fucking piss out of him. All
right. I'm not going to lie and say top 10.
You should, though. That's what she's looking for. Is the
she
lie.
Also didn't
she
make
wants
it.
The lie.
This
doesn't
is her,
matter.
Oh wait, she didn't make it.
This has nothing. This was her family's
doesn't
Thanksgiving.
Matter.
So Charlie, I mean, on a normal day, who does most of the? Who does really does the cooking in your house between you and you and Krista?
I mean, what? What do you call her?
Tardy.
No, I said I'm trying to say on a normal day.
Well, she's with you,
excluding the holidays.
It's an interesting nickname.
Who does the cooking? You or Krista? Is what I was trying
you
to ask you.
Nickname in private.
Somebody popped up briefly.
Oh,
on
yeah?
On my video, but it's just a still image of his face right now. But
oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
There is Jeffrey on his walk into work, his annual walk into work.
He's got a smile on
he's
his
so
face.
Happy.
He's
yeah.
so happy
I love
right
that.
Now. What time did you head out of your house?
3:53 this morning.
Okay, bright and early. Do you stop for food or a break?
A little Dunkin'.
Coffee.
I stopped for coffee when I started out.
What did you eat beforehand to prepare?
Yeah, just a sausage biscuit from the gas station.
Oh, okay.
Oh, those right. are fresh.
Yes.
Wait, you go to...
No,
go
I microwaved it for 30 seconds, Peter. You know, sausage and cheese.
All right, he's wearing...
Looks very dark. We all told him to wear reflective gear, and it looks like you're wearing
all black.
Oh, yeah. All black. This is the actual outfit you were wearing when you got ran over before.
Is it okay. Actually?
Yes, the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. Black.
Wait, hold on a second. So you were wearing that jacket the night you were hit by a car crossing the street?
Yeah.
And you decided, I'm going to walk 5 hours to work in the dark. I'm going to wear that same jacket already been hit. I guess
it's a black jean jacket.
Let's not forget the Trans-Siberian Orchestra's logo is on the back, and it's reflective.
No, it isn't. It's just white thread.
Yeah, and did it work last time you got hit by a car?
This is not a good luck charm. Your all black jean jacket.
Black jeans, black hat.
What color are your pants? Maybe you're
black.
Wow. Yeah, black right. Shoes.
Why are you doing this?
He wants to blend in with the asphalt.
Hi.
How's it going? It looks like it's a little bit lighter out there. Sun's starting to come up. Yep. Tell me how the walk is going.
I had to take a double bathroom break.
Again?
A double bathroom break. What does that mean?
It means that I had to drop a deuce and take a pee.
Oh, where'd you do it at?
And a pee?
How much water are you drinking?
I thought the same thing.
No, I'm on my second cup of coffee.
Yeah. So more caffeine, more dehydrated. You're going to cramp up. You're not going to finish this.
If I had two extra arms, I could wipe my ass and answer my phone at the same fucking time.
Oh, wow.
Already an F-bomb.
How many more miles do you think you have?
I don't know.
Can we see your footwear? We were wondering what kind of shoes you were going to wear. Can you pause for a second? So I can see him.
There he is.
Are they tennis shoes or your boots?
Boots.
Are those the steel toe boots?
Yep.
Any water in you yet?
Nope.
Probably less danger than he was earlier today, walking in his all black outfit at 4 o'clock in the morning, pitch black, making his way into work for the, what is this called, Charlie?
The Jeffrey Allen Roke pre-diabetes, pre-memorial walk to work.
All right. And this is all to bring awareness to
pre-diabetes, which Jeffrey is a known sufferer of.
11.6 miles.
I made it. Any sales girls here?
He's going to sit down at the oldie station and let him know.
I'm Jeffrey the intern.
He's waiting for us to go to commercial break, which we have to go to in just a moment.
There he is. Whoa, you going to get donuts?
What's in that thing?
He got coffee and donuts.
Good job, Jeffrey.
He has made it. He has arrived safely.
Oh, come on in.
He's coming into the studio. He's kicked the door open. Wow.
How do you donate?
I got the Cash App, dude.
We got a wedding video here. I don't know. If Jeffrey, did you do this when you got married? Did you, what is it, carry your wife?
Across the threshold?
Across the threshold. Did you do that?
Yeah, I did that when we stayed in a small apartment when we first got married.
And so when you came back on your wedding night, you carried her across the threshold?
Yeah, of course, she was like lighter at the time. We had the kids. She had the kids. Can't carry her now.
Snitches, so. Did you do it?
Yeah, you have to. It's like it's the law.
Okay.
Well, there's always like one good-looking guest, right? So we'd have to highlight Dieter. I mean, Dieter's really the only person in shape here, right? So we'd have to like get Dieter shirtless, oil him up.